And it's my pleasure to introduce our next speaker. Kjeld Abo is a mechanical engineer from Copenhagen with also a diploma in sales and marketing. He joined MAN BMW Diesel in 1983 and has basically been working on two-stroke marine engines for the whole of his life, starting as a project engineer to a group manager, to a senior manager in engineering, then becoming the head of the research center in Copenhagen, to the head of two-stroke promotion worldwide, to the head of marine and offshore, spending 3 years in Brazil, and currently he is the director for promotion of two-stroke engines back in Copenhagen. His expertise spans lubes and fuels emissions, as well as gas fuel engines, and next to that, he's also been the chairman of the International CEMEC Fuel Working Group for over 20 years. So with that, Kjeld, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Can you also see my screen?
Yes, we can.
Okay, good. I will talk about the engines. A little bit about two-stroke engine, a little bit about our portfolio, you could say. We are not the ones to say what will be the future fuel, but definitely methanol is one we believe very much in. I'm normally sitting here, but we are all called home because of the reason that obviously still is very bad also here in Denmark. But normally we sit here in this office, we are about 1,300 people, sorry. We design and develop our two-stroke engine here. We have colleagues in Augsburg designing and developing the four-stroke engines. We also have a small production. We have a prime serve academy to educate the marine engineers for our engines. And then we have a research center. 12 years ago, I was in charge of the research center. At that time, I had 30 engineers in the group. Today, there are 65 plus engineers in the research center, and we have just actually installed a new test engine. So we have two. The last decade have been so many different tests. It's regarding emission control. It's a regarding new engines as the new GA auto process LNG engine we have. It's like all the different fuels, and we test with all the different fuels many times, many tests before it's launched into the market. We have as such more than 1.5 million operating hours at dual fuel engines. So we have quite an, you can say, a experience. And when we talk experience, it's not only the use of the these low sulfur fuel itself, it also to a certain extent necessary to obtain still a very good cylinder condition and piston ring condition and configuration and so on, and have the right lube oil actually added to the cylinders. The lube oil amount and also base number is very much dependent of the sulfur content in the fuel, whatever fuel it is. But the detergency is very important, and there we work closely to oil companies and additive companies to actually have better detergency, low BN oils for the market. But we are working in the right direction. Today we have sold 235 GI engine for methanol. We have sold 26, ethane 28, and propane 42. So you see there is a variety of different fuels that we can use in our portfolio. Our portfolio goes from, for two-stroke engine, goes from 3 megawatt up to 85 megawatt. Or 83 megawatt, and goes from a bore size on 30 centimeter up to 95. There's a lot of overlap, but that's also because two-stroke engines are for vessels, primarily for vessels larger than 2,000 deadweight ton, and all different type of applications, all container vessels, tankers, and so forth. And that's there, the propulsion, two-stroke engine propulsion is far from, is very much dominating. This is just a picture to show you that we can go to very, very big sizes and big monsters here. This is from one of our licensees and an engine being on testbed, such an engine here. I guess it's about a 95 bore engine. It will have a weight of about 2,400 tons. So, and a huge consumption, which will be maybe about 400 tons of methanol, if methanol was the fuel. We don't have it designed for methanol yet, but I'm sure this will be coming. This is something market have to show us what is, what of our Indian portfolio should actually be ready for operating on methanol. But more is coming now. We do a lot of effort to have more and more Indians being able to operate on the methanol. And it's not the technical part. It's actually the work for the drawings and also to ensure that we can have, you can say, be in compliance with the NOx certificates and so on, especially in, when we talk about retrofitting. Retrofitting have been mentioned before. And what we have done lately is that we have started up retrofitting for a company, BW Gas, to retrofit up to nine of their LPG tankers to operate on LPG. So today we have this liquid gas injection engines that go for methanol and LPG. We have ethane and methane for the GI, which is a gaseous gas injected with a high pressure 300 bar and so on. But here it's liquid. And methanol have a very simple system compared to the gaseous systems that I come a little bit back to. This is the history, 2015, first test. Next, third test on a test engine. We had sea trial 2016, and now we have nine vessels plus operating on methanol for quite a while. This is our standard fuel oil burning engine. When I do this, you see what pop out here is what we do of modification to make it a dual fuel engine. Are we looking at one cylinder, cross-section of a cylinder, you will see that there's only those parts that are different from a fuel oil burning engine. We have the cover here to the cylinder. We have the extra dual fuel valves. We still have the same fuel oil valve because that's both used for when you operate only on fuel oil and also as injecting the pilot oil. We have a gas block. We have a chain link for double wall piping due to safety and so on. Yeah, if we look at the different concepts, I think this is, yeah, oh. This is the combustion illustration. What actually happens is we inject the pilot oil and it ignites, and then we inject the methanol exactly directly into the burning flame of the pilot oil. And in that way, we can control the burning process. It gives exactly the same high efficiency as when you are operating on diesel. It's acting, the engine is acting exactly the same way as you. The operator do not feel if he's operating on diesel or methanol. There's no restrictions when using methanol as such. Same output, same power, same efficiency, and so forth. And that makes it very, very easy, especially also when we come and we talk about retrofit. We have also retrofitted to LNG, and there is a lot of projects for retrofitting. We do believe there will be a lot of that also for methanol. We have actually developed a system to be in compliance with Tier 3, NOx Tier 3, by just adding water to the methanol. It's very, very easy and a very simple concept. And when we do that in the right way, we will have the water as a part of the methanol. The water needs to, you can say, it's heated up in the temperature in there that reduce the peak temperature in the combustion chamber. And the peak temperature is where actually the NOx is built up. So when you're in Tier 3, you use water in the methanol. What we have done also is that for the last orders, we have actually made another concept also, and that is instead of having an SCR or an EGR to cover when you are operating in fuel oil mode, then we actually also add or inject water your fuel oil into the water. It's a special concept, but here you can actually also reach tier three. We don't have it in the program for the other vessels yet, but I'm sure it will come to a certain extent because it's also a very simple way with diesel to actually meet tier three. Here is just some examples, which could be. It could be a 50-bore tanker that have this. It could be a 15,000 container vessels that operates on methanol. Here we just see the fuel gas supply system, and I would say, before going into such a design and such put it such an engine in the portfolio, one thing is the safety on the engine itself, but there's also on the fuel gas supply systems, we go into a number of hazard investigations. And that was, as also mentioned before, for the first methanol engine, it was not categorized in any standards and so on. It was something that there was giving acceptance from flag state, and then we started up. And as you saw now, 26 of those engines are installed. So here is the simple water to the methanol injected and so on. Thank you very much.
We have a couple of questions lined up for you, I hope.
Okay.
Okay, so the first question is whether the cylinder oil used in traditional engines, will that be different from the oil that you're going to have to use in the engine when it's running on methanol?
It will be the same oil as it, if you compare, for instance, that you are operating on very low sulfur fuel oil. It will be the same cylinder lube oil you will use for methanol, because it is the sulfur content in the fuel that is, you can say, dictating what feed weight and also BN number should be used.
Okay, thanks. And then a question on the water content of that water methanol blend you mentioned. What's the ratio between the two that you need?
There is an advantage, also another advantage with methanol, that is that actually, in the chemical process, burning process and so on, you will have a 30 to 50% reduced NOx level compared to fuel oil. And that means that you already are quite low compared to normal fuel oil, where you use SCR and EGR systems. So you add fuel oil, but it's add water, but it's less than you add of the quantity of fuel you are. I'm not sure I really remember how much. I don't remember how much it is, but my guess is maybe about 30 to 40%. But I would like to come back to that question.
Yeah, okay. And then we have a question again touching on ammonia. There's a lot of talk now about potential competition between methanol and ammonia. Do you have any insights already into the combustion performance on these two fuels, how they compare?
I would say it will be harder to actually burn the ammonia in itself. And we are starting up the test in January 2021, so it's very soon. We are doing that because of the market's interest. And it is very big, the market's interest. And you can see it's increasing, as also mentioned before, the methanol interest in methanol is also increasing very much as we see it. So for me, it's like those two. And we also expect that there in the end will be many or several different fuels, non-carbon fuel or carbon neutral fuels out there. So we don't believe that it will just be one. We believe that there will be a lot of methanol used, there will be a lot of ammonia used, and maybe also some hydrogen.
Yeah.
We have an engine on testbed in 2024 that can produce, that can operate on ammonia. But first test next year will show how hard it is to burn ammonia, but definitely it's harder than it is with methanol, and it could call for more pilot oil than we do use for the methanol.
Okay, thank you. Then we have another question on the oil feeds. We mentioned methanol versus other alternatives. What about the oil feeds versus HFO? And then I guess they're referring to quantities, to the amount of oil being consumed.
We have on cylinder loop oil, we have a minimum on 0.6 gram per kilowatt hour. And that is what you need when you have a low sulfur fuel as the methanol. If you have a high sulfur, as you do for heavy fuel oil, then you can maybe be above 1, 1.2 or something like that. It's all dependent on the sulfur content. Yeah.
So it's actually lower than the HFO?
Yes.
Okay. Then I think we've run through our questions, and then we're perfectly on time to have a break. So I hope you will join us back at 10 to 11. So go ahead and stretch your legs, get a cup of coffee, and then join us again 10 to 11. And don't forget to post questions on Menti. So be back to you soon.